Hello students, welcome to Misostudy. In this today's live online session, we will be discussing about how our heart look like, what is the structure of heart, what are the different arteries and veins which is present in them. Heart is that word which we normally use in our day-to-day life. Someone says that my heart is broken, some says my heart is with you, and all these kinds of words they normally use. But actually this is quite different. After this whole session of 30 to 40 minutes, you will realize that there is a quite difference what we say and what exactly the heart is. Heart is just a pumping organ, a very vital organ that pumps blood to the various organs, various structures, various cells of the body. Right? Students, this whole session we will be dealing with the different cardiac cycle, the pumping, how this pumping occurs, how this blood is translocated, this blood is transported to the various organs, various cells of the body. Similarly, we will be discussing about that how this heart function, what do you mean by the contraction, what do you mean by the relaxation, what do you mean by the systole and the diastole, what are the different veins, what are the different arteries which is present in our heart. So we will be discussing all those one by one. First of all, I'll start the session with the structure of heart. Let's take a general introduction regarding the heart. Let's look at that. When we see an adult heart, it is like a shape, or you can say the size is just like our fist. It's not that heart shape that we normally draw, that non-science students they used to draw, that and everyone used to draw like this. This is not that. Actually, our heart look like this. This is the structure of a heart. Various arteries, various veins, they arise from it. Some carries oxygenated blood, some carries deoxygenated blood. In case of the human heart, we have four chambers. Two are the atria and the two ventricles, they are present. Right ventricle, right atria, they do some separate function. Left atria, left ventricle, they do some separate function. So let's start with general introduction regarding the heart. So today, introduction. Let's talk about the size of heart, size of adult heart. What's the size? That is around 12 centimeter. I'm talking about the adult heart, right? When we see that actual in grams, we can see that in case of male, in case of a male, that is around 0.45% of total body weight, or around 0.40 to 0.45% of body weight. When we see in case of the male, this is quite heavier as compared to the female one, that is around 280 to 340 gram in case of male, whereas in case of a female, we are talking about now in case of female, this is around 230 to 280. Now the question arises where this heart is located. Heart is located in between the lungs. Where this is located? Located between lungs. Now, they are located in between the lungs. In between the lungs, we have a mediastinum in which it is present. Mediastinum in which it is present, right? And when we see that it is more towards the left side, right? More towards left side. More towards left side, right? It is tilted towards the left side. Let's talk about the whole structure of this heart. When we see the whole structure, this whole structure is enclosed in a double membrane, and that membrane is called as pericardium. Now come at this side so that we can discuss about the covering of heart. Heart covering. Heart covering. Double membrane structure, and that double membrane structure is called as pericardium. And these double membrane is called as pericardium. Pericardium. In the pericardium only, as I have told you, this is of double membrane. That means they are made up of two membrane. So in the pericardium only, we have two type of membrane present. One is called as a visceral and another is called as a parietal. Visceral and parietal. When we see that these two layers, they play a very important role. In between, as I've told you, that pericardium is composed of two layers. In between these two layers, the pericardial fluid is present. Now, what is the function of these pericardial fluid? They prevent the heart from the mechanical damage. In between two membranes, in between two membrane, what we have is a space, and that space is called as pericardial space. Pericardial space. Pericardial space, right? And this pericardial space has a fluid, and that is called as pericardial fluid. That is called as pericardial fluid. Pericardial fluid. These pericardial fluid, the function of these is that they prevent the heart from the mechanical damage. Whenever we feel some kind of shock, these pericardial fluid, which is present in between them, they absorb that shock so that our main organ, the main vital organ, that is a heart, will not get affected. Right, so this is the reason for that. So whenever someone says, like this is a joke I'm telling you, that whenever someone says that my heart is broken, just ask one question from my side. Do you have pericardial fluid? If you have pericardial fluid, then how you can say that your heart is broken? So they prevent from the mechanical damage. Now let's discuss about, hope you have noted down about this pericardium and the pericardial fluid. Now let's discuss about some muscles which is present in the heart. Muscular layers. In the heart, the three muscular layers, they are present. One is called as epicardium. Epicardium, right? Epicardium layer is present. Second we have is the myocardium. Myocardium, right? And the third we have is the endocardium. Endocardium, right? As the name indicates, epicardium, that means such type of muscular layer will be present towards the outer side. And when we see the exact structure of these, they are basically made up of striated cells. They are mainly the major kind of muscles, this is present in them. In case of the myocardium, that means this is present in between the epicardium and the endocardium. Cardiac muscles which provide involuntary action, which helps in contraction and relaxation, this is present in the myocardium. So, in the myocardium, the striated muscles, they are present. Striated muscles, they are present. And these striated muscles, they are of very much importance because of these striated muscles, they can contract easily. And our main function of heart is a contraction only. So, they help in contraction and they show involuntary action. Such muscles, they are also called as cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscles, right? So, out of these, outermost we have this epicardium, in between we have this myocardium, and towards internal side we have this endocardium present, right? Now, come at this side. As I have told you, this whole structure is covered by one membrane, and when we remove this membrane, I can see that the four chambers, they are present. They have two atria and two ventricles they have. Towards the anterior side, we can see that atria are present. Towards the posterior side, these ventricles, they are present. This is a whole structure. This is called as the upper one, this is called as an atria, and below one is called as a ventricle. Now, removal of this pericardium, shows two important structures. One is called as atria and another is called as a ventricle. Atria and second is called as a ventricle. Right? So, this was a quite common for you all that this is the structure of heart. You must have studied of the structure of heart in your previous classes as well. Now, let's discuss about the structure of atria, then we will discuss about the structure of ventricle. Then what I'll do, I'll label all those things in this diagram. So, let's discuss about atria. What is atria? Right? Atria is present towards the anterior side. They are present towards the anterior side. Right? Two chambers we have. In the human heart, we have two chambers of atria. This is a characteristic feature of human. That means they are having a four-chambered heart. So, two chambers they have. One is called as a right chamber and another is called as a left chamber. Right atria and left atria. Right, or you can write the chamber as well as atria. When we talk about these two, we can see that some grooves, they are present. Come at this side. Can you see such grooves over here? These grooves, they are present. These are called as auriculoventricular groove. So, in between the atria and ventricle, we have auriculoventricular groove. So, this marks the boundary between the auricle and ventricle. In between auricle and ventricle. Now, I will tell you the reason why I am writing in between now. Because after this writing, I will discuss about what is the septum which is present between the two atria, right? In between auricle and ventricles, the groove which is present that is called as auriculoventricular groove. That is called as auriculoventricular groove. Now, as I am telling you again and again that we have a two chamber. One is this one and another is this one. Now, there should be some marked boundary between these, and that marked boundary is called as interauricular septum. So, in between these we can see that a boundary is there. Boundary between atria and that boundary between atria is called as interauricular septum. When we see that this is the whole structure of an atria, the two atria is there, one is called as a right atria and another is called as a left atria. In case of the right atria, that right atria, they have a deoxygenated blood, whereas the left atria has oxygenated blood. Now let's see. Right atria or right auricle, it has deoxygenated blood. Whereas the left atria, that left atria is having oxygenated blood. So this you have to remember. Another important feature as per your atria is considered that they are having some fine fiber like structure that is called as musculi pectinati. In atria, what we have? Fine fibers. And you can call it as some muscular elevations are there, low muscular elevations. And what is the name of that low muscular elevation? Musculi pectinati. So this is all about the atria. Now come at this side where these atria, they are present. Let's discuss with the help of this diagram. You can see that the atria, one atria is present over here, one atria is present over here. We are talking about, this is suppose I am doing some surgery and I have to check that which is on the right side and which is on the left side. So the right and the left of a doctor doesn't determine over here that this is a right chamber or this is the left chamber. This is according to the patient which is lying down. So that means according to this patient, suppose this is a heart of a patient, it is like this. His right will be on this side, left will be on this side. This will be called as right auricle. Whereas this is called as left auricle. Now, can you see that such structure is there? When we talk about the right auricle, in the right auricle, we can see that the deoxygenated blood is there. Whereas in case of the left auricle, we have the oxygenated blood. Below this left auricle, we have another structure which is called as left ventricle. This is a left ventricle. Right. Whereas this structure below or to the posterior side of right auricle we have is a right ventricle. Right ventricle. Now, similarly, when I say that, now listen to this carefully, when I say that these are the two auricles present, in between we have that septum that is called as interauricular septum. Now tell me what is the name of this septum. Blindly you can write that this is interventricular septum. So what is this? This is interventricular septum. Right, interventricular septum. So, hope the things are somehow clear to you that how these four chambers they are present in them. We have discussed about this type of the partition or the septum. Similarly, the partition will be present over here as well. That marks a boundary between auricle and ventricle and auricle and ventricle over here as well. Such type of boundary is called as atrioventricular septum. Atrioventricular septum. Various, you can see the various structures, or can you see this blue structure and this red structure? Various veins, various arteries, they arise from it. And each of these arteries and the vein, they have some specific functions. Some carry oxygenated and some deoxygenated, that we have discussed that. So, after this, we'll study some ventricles, and like that, I have told you that musculi pectinity is present in the auricle. Similarly, in case of the ventricle, certain ridges, they are present that are called as papillary muscles and that are called as chordae tendae. So, what are these? Papillary muscle. Whereas, this is called as chordae tendae. Chordae tendae. So, this is a whole structure of an heart. There is some specific function of these papillary muscles and the chordae tendae. Some specific function is there. Now, what is that specific function? Is that in between the auricle and ventricle, valve is present over here. Similarly, in between this left auricle and the left ventricle, some valve is present over here. Now, valve is what? Valve is that structure that regulates that this blood has to flow from this chamber to this chamber, or it has not to flow. So, they keep a check on the flow of the blood. Similarly, these some structures, they are present over here, and these are called as a valve. These are called as a tricuspid and the bicuspid valve, right? So, we can see that towards the left side we have, this is called as bicuspid valve. Whereas towards this right hand side, we have another valve that is called as a tricuspid valve. So that I am labeling over here. This is a tricuspid valve. As I have told you, these papillary muscles, they are present, and chordae tendae are present. I am not saying that they are present only towards one side, they are present only towards the left side. I am not saying that. They are present all towards the ventricle, they are present all on the inner side of the ventricle. So, there might be some specific function for that. The specific function of this is that the papillary muscle and the chordae tendae is that they prevent that these valve which is present in between them, they should not get invert. So, the function of these papillary muscles and chordae tendae prevent inversion of these valve which is present in them, right? Now, let's talk about these. Some more muscular ridges, they are also present. Some more muscular ridges, they are also present. They are present in case of, present on inner side. Of ventricle, and these are quite high, and such are called as trabeculae carneae. Right? Now we have studied about the four chamber of a heart, two atricles and two ventricles. Now let's discuss about the valve. As I have told you, the two valve till now, one is called as a tricuspid valve and another is called as a bicuspid valve. The function of this bicuspid valve is that whenever blood has to flow from these ventricles, when blood has to flow from these ventricles towards heart, as I have told you that this right is having deoxygenated blood. When this right one is having a deoxygenated blood, whenever its pumping occurs, these deoxygenated blood has to go out. Now, where these go out? These directly enter into this structure which is called as pulmonary arch. This pulmonary arch, they supply blood towards both the lungs. Because this is a deoxygenated blood has to reach where? They has to go to the lungs so that the exchange of gases can occur, so that the CO2 has to release and the this oxygen has to enter. That means a conversion of deoxygenated blood to the oxygenated blood. So they go towards both the direction, one towards the right, or sorry, one towards the left direction, one towards the this right direction. So this is called as, this structure is called as left pulmonary arch, whereas this structure, this pulmonary arch open here as well. So this will be called as right pulmonary arch. After this, from the ventricles only, one more structure arises, that is called as a aortic arch. We have pumped that deoxygenated blood. Now it's time to pump oxygenated blood as well. And oxygenated blood is present where? This is present in the left ventricle. So from the left ventricle, one aortic arch arises, and this aortic arch, they supplies the blood to the various organ. This oxygenated blood, they has to supply the blood to the various organs. This further divides themselves into certain various structures. These go to the various cells, various organs where they supply the blood. So this is called as aortic arch. Now, question arises from where it arises? This arises from the left ventricle. Whereas we have this aortic arch present, similarly, I have drawn some structures over here as well. Can you see such structures? This is also aortic arch. The same aortic arch is spread blood towards each and every side. Similarly, some structures, they are present over here as well. These are called as a superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Let's label these as well. This is called as superior vena cava. Superior vena cava, they enter the blood, they enter the deoxygenated blood directly into the this right auricle or the right atrium. They take the blood from upper body parts, they pump the deoxygenated blood towards the right auricle, and that superior vena cava is also called as pre-caval. Whereas this inferior vena cava is called as post-caval. That means what it do? It takes all those deoxygenated blood which is coming from the various cells in the organ and they supply towards the right auricle. So this is called as inferior vena cava. So such type of different, you can say, these structures, they are present. I have written over here the pulmonary arch. Similarly, can you see these structures, these two structures over here, and similarly these two structures over here? They are also for specific reason. I have told you that, now listen to this very carefully. Deoxygenated blood is entering over here into the right this auricle. As a deoxygenated blood is entering over here, what it will do? It will contract itself so that the blood can enter into the ventricle. Some deoxygenated blood, they will enter into the ventricle, and this deoxygenated blood, they will go to the this pulmonary arch, and they will go to the lungs so that this deoxygenated blood is converted into the oxygenated blood. Now let's focus on the left ventricle. Now what happens is that in the left ventricle, we can see that pumping of blood occur. We have oxygenated blood, similarly oxygenated blood present over here as well. They are separated from each other by the bicuspid wall. When the contraction of this left auricle occur, the blood, they enter into the this left ventricle. From that left ventricle, they will go towards the aortic arch. And it spread the blood to the various organs. So this ventricular contraction, ventricular relaxation, or atrial contraction and atrial relaxation, this is called as heartbeat, right? And this is very important. If this will stop working, you will not be able to survive, because each and every organ of your body, each and every cell of your body, they need oxygen. Why they need oxygen? Because they have to carry out the various metabolic processes. And we have already studied why this oxygen is necessary. That's why they need oxygen. So when this oxygen supply is hindered, when this contraction is stopped over here, will you be able to survive? No, you will not be able to survive. Suddenly what will happen? Your brain oxygen supply will stop. Brain oxygen supply will stop, rest all will go. So this is an important structure of an heart. We have discussed about the different this valve. Similarly, I have told you the two structures, they come towards this side. Now the contraction is occurring over here as well. The contraction is occurring. That means from where this heart, this is having oxygenated blood. Now this oxygenated blood, this comes from lungs only. Because that oxygenated, deoxygenated blood which is going towards the lungs, that has to be exchanged, so oxygenated blood. So this is the rich supply, this is the supply of the oxygenated blood. This is called as a pulmonary vein. Right? Normally a vein always carry a deoxygenated blood. Whereas the exception is that in case of the pulmonary vein, these conditions, they are opposite, they carry oxygenated blood. They carry oxygenated blood from lungs to left atria. So can you see that I have these two structures over here, these will get this oxygenated blood from the left side and they will get the oxygenated blood from the right lungs. So similarly, this is called as pulmonary vein, right side pulmonary vein, right side pulmonary vein. They are also two in number, these two structure, they are also two in number and they are also two in number. Right, this is an whole structure of an heart. Similarly, some valves, they are also present towards this side also. Right, this is also called as a aortic valve. Now, function of this aortic valve is that whenever the contraction occurs, basically it arises from the left ventricle, this goes and they arise from this left ventricle. And when we see that whenever this contraction is occurring, after this contraction, the relaxation will occur. If this relaxation will occur, the blood has to, we have to stop the blood from entering again into the left ventricle. So, this is done by our valve which is present over here, which is called as a aortic arch. Now, let's see how this blood is supplied to various organs. Flow of blood. First of all, the deoxygenated blood, let's talk about the deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood, that means it is having a more carbon dioxide, less oxygen is present in them. This deoxygenated blood from the two sides, one from the upper side and one from the lower side, they enter into the right auricle. When they enter into the right auricle, they enter by a superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Inferior vena cava, and they will enter into the right auricle. Now we have this deoxygenated blood into the right auricle. From here, the contraction of this right auricle will occur and they will supply a blood to the right ventricle. Now, I have blood in the right ventricle, deoxygenated blood is there. Now, my work is to carry this deoxygenated blood to the lungs. Now, how this passage will occur? This passage will be because of the pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery, and from pulmonary artery, it will go towards the lungs. Go towards the lung. Now, this is the most easy way by which you can remember the pumping of the deoxygenated blood. Now, let's talk about oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood is that blood which enters into the right side, and in the right side, first of all, they enter into the left side. When they enter into the left side, with the help of pulmonary veins, and they are coming from lungs, pulmonary vein, and from pulmonary vein, they enter into the left auricle. From left auricle, they will enter into the left ventricle. Left ventricle. From the left ventricle, they will enter into the aortic arch. And from aortic arch, they will enter into the various body parts. Various body parts. So, this is the whole circulation of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Now, let's look at the second structure. In the second structure, I have shown you the various valve, they are present. various valves which are present. So what are these various valves? This is called as the tricuspid and the bicuspid valve. This is from the upper view. Tricuspid valve and the bicuspid valve, and these are what? Semilunar valves, right? These are the semilunar valve which is present. When we see that how our heart actually pumps, basically the conduction of nerve impulse, they start from the SA node, then they go towards the AV node. SA node is also called as a pacemaker, whereas this AV node is called as a pace setter. Later on, they enter into these structure, which is called as bundle of His. And from bundle of His, can you see this yellow colored further branching? This is called as Purkinje fibers, and they help in contraction and relaxation of the blood. With this contraction and relaxation, the blood is supplied to the various part of the body. So students, this is all about the today's session. In the next session, we will be discussing how this whole blood pumps into the various part of the body. Similarly, we will be talking about the systole and the diastole. We will be talking about how this cardiac cycle occurs. Similarly, we have another topic which is called as electrocardiogram. This is important for the survival. If our heart will stop working, then we will die. So this is the whole structure which is called as an electrocardiogram. This we will be discussing in the next session. Students, in this whole session, we have discussed some important points which is related to the heart. So our whole meso study is based upon this particular criteria only, where we based upon these online lectures, we provide a good quality online lectures. After that, we used to give some lectures which are based upon the questions. And these questions, they are made by our different teams, different parts, or the different, we have separate department for the physics, chemistry, and the biology. In the separate department, the separate questions, they are prepared, and they are important for the NEET. Depending upon the previous exams, we set the question, we prepare such type of lecture, and we give it to the students. So students, if you want to buy, you can come to our site, that is misostudy.com. Students, this is all about today's lecture. We'll meet you next session.